even in our worst imagination, we hadn't imagined that you could pay somebody on WhatsApp 500 rupees and get access to a database of a billion people. Tribune story is not the first story, and it's not going to be the last story about security leaks by Aadhaar. Bharti Airtel is one of the ASAs, and Bharti Airtel was charged with taking your Aadhaar information and opening payment bank accounts in your name and diverting subsidies to those bank accounts. So the fraud is at the core. And these guys have no idea about security or no conception of security, right? And they were just putting out people's information along with bank information out in the open. If you go to a what is called a point of sale terminal, right? So you go to your Kinara store, you go to a Airtel shop, a Vodafone shop, to give your Aadhaar, to give your fingerprints and your Aadhaar number. Now, what is to say that the scanner, the fingerprint scanner or the iris scanner they have, that there is not a skimmer, right, which is making a copy of your biometrics? They already have your Aadhaar number. So if that guy is a criminal, your Kinara store is a criminal, he can easily take a copy of your biometrics, he has your Aadhaar number, and he can impersonate you. But even assuming that that guy is honest, but let's say the laptop or the PC to which the scanner is connected to, let's say that has a virus, that is a malware, right? And that malware intercepts the biometrics and skims it off. So they have stolen your biometrics. So you can talk about scammers, about phishing gangs, about, it's also a national security threat, right? So people from abroad can get intimate information about every citizen, and the government seems to be callous about that. If you look at it, you cannot cancel Aadhaar card, Aadhaar number. It's for life. So if your Aadhaar gets compromised, you are done for life. You cannot change the password because your biometrics can't be changed, right? And there is no limit, right? The Aadhaar is linked to your every bank account, supposedly, right? The government is forcing you to do that. It is linked to your phone. It is linked to every, now they're saying that to get admitted to school, you need an Aadhaar card. To go to a hospital, you need an Aadhaar card.
Even when you are dying, you need an
Aadhaar card. Even after your death, you need an Aadhaar card for your relatives to get your death certificate. And so everything is linked to this one number, which cannot be revoked, whose PIN you can't change. It is, by design, is a security nightmare.
The biometric database has never been audited by anybody. It was interesting to hear Mr. Pandey's explanation of what this is. First, he says that this is a 16-digit number. You don't have to give your number then to everybody. But if there are some people where you're mandated to give it, then you have to give your UID number there. So there are places where you're going to display your UID number. Then they say that there are large numbers of people in this country who won't be able to operate the system of getting, of generating a 16-digit number. They can continue using the UID number. So it is not, it's optional in the sense that if you are a geek and you know how to keep, playing the system where you can, like he said, every second you can generate a 16-digit number, that's fine. But for most people, they are not going to have this choice. They are not going to know how to exercise this choice.